From the ITU headquarters in Geneva, I'm pleased today to have Ms. Vinod Kotwal, who is the Deputy Director General at the Department of Telecommunications in India. Welcome, Vinod.
Thank you, Bilal.
As you know, we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the World Telecommunications and Information Society Day on 17 May. And the theme this year is Bridging Standardization Gap. So we wanted to talk to you about your experience in Study Group 3 as a chair of the Working Party, as well as the chair of a regional group for Asia and Oceania. And what are the key success factors that helped you personally and as a group in bridging the standardization gap?
First of all, as we know that ITU is the specialized UN agency looking into information communication and information communication technologies, one of the important functions that ITU performs is of standard setting. And for any standard setting to be inclusive, we need to have more participation from people from all over the world. And I feel bridging the standardization program that you have at ITU empowers people with giving them the right skills and the knowledge to participate actively in the standard setting process. Personally, I attended my first meeting of SG3, which was a regional group meeting of AO in 2015 in Kuala Lumpur. I attended bridging the standardization session there, found it to be extremely useful. And then we carried forward this collaboration when UN Lara came to India in 2016, and we had a bridging the standardization session in India. And then again, December 2018. So this I'm talking about at a country level. However, as a chair of AO group and also Working Party for chair, I think the most important learning that I've had from this sessions is the confidence which these sessions provide you on having the right skills to how to not only access documents, collaborate, build consensus, because ultimately that's what we are looking at, a consensus building process which leads to standards that are useful to everyone.
Very good. And what would you say some of the advice that you might give to newcomers, to new delegates, men or women coming into the ITU process on some of the key principles of working in the ITU?
I think it's a very pertinent question that you have asked, because for a newcomer, the whole process of attending the meetings and accessing the documents can be quite overwhelming. But again, I would take them back to bridging the standardization program that you have, because there's a online program also that you have on working methods of ITUT, which is a program which you do online, and you at the end of it you get the certificate also. So you know you have the bare, I would say, the framework which is made available to you to access documents. And as newcomers, the only piece of advice I can give to you is that there are so many questions, there is so many work which is happening. But what you need to do as a country is to strategize and see what is important for you, and maybe zero down upon those questions, because you can't be writing contributions, meaningful contributions on all questions. So you once you know that these are the questions that I would like to work on those contributions, and also discuss with other delegates, collaborate. And then when you come to the meeting, you have to do both formal as well as informal interactions. And it's a process of consensus building that you have to go through for your contribution to, maybe develop as a technical report or as a recommendation or any, normative as well as informative document.
Ms. Vinod Kotwal, thank you very much for joining us today. And I wish you a happy 17th of May, World Telecom and Information Society Day.
Thank you so much, Bilal, for having me. It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you.